In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. In the Gospel of this Sunday, according to Mark chapter 9, verse 2 to 10, we hear about the transfiguration of our Lord Jesus Christ. Last Sunday, we heard about the temptation of Jesus, and that highlighted the humanity of Jesus, because he became one of us, even to the point of being tempted by the devil. The transfiguration, my dear brothers and sisters, reflects his divinity. He manifested his glory to three of his disciples, namely Peter, James, and John. And his appearance changed. We can see that the story of the transfiguration is placed after the first passion prediction. That means that his triumph will come through his suffering and death. And Jesus knew very well that his disciples would have difficulty to accept his suffering and death. And my dear brothers and sisters, we always enjoy good moments, good times, as Peter, James, and John. And even to the point that Peter wanted to remain there at the place of transfiguration, he even asked whether it was possible to build three tents or three booths. No one wants to hear about difficulty or hard time, but as Christians, let us not only expect a moment of glory from God, let us remain faithful to God even when things are not going the way we want. And finally, let us be always willing to walk together with others in their moments of trial, their moments of suffering. May God grant us that grace. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.